And you could see there was some kind of interrogation going on, and the, whatever was being interrogated thinged out. And you could see the chair and the rope and everything. And then Juan got a little too close to it, thinking it was dead, and apparently it wasn't dead. The legs weren't dead. It was stunned, obviously. And now he's in trouble because he's got a hold of him. There's nothing I can do for you, Juan. I'm sorry. Yeah. These sound effects are from The Blob. The Blob 1988 remake. I had to find some sound effects that were not from the thing. Oh, this is... There's Chud. That's the sound effect from Chud. And then here comes... Juan's really pissed. He wants through that door. And goddammit, he's gonna get through that door. That came out great. This is, right there. The little club is added afterwards. So that's a composite right there. And this is, Don Shug and Tyson. They're the Thing Hunters. They're trying... What he said was, is give him the test. And they were gonna give me the blood test. But then they got interrupted by Diaz thing there. And then this is me grabbing me. It's actually Frank. So there's, this is my garage at home. It's supposed to be like a janitor's closet. This scene is actually much longer. We'll come back to that. This is the Thing Hunters. This Frank inside the costume there is no longer Juan Diaz. And they did not use the flamethrower because the flamethrower don't work. So Tyson was there just to die. He's like the red shirt guy in Star Trek. He was just there to get killed. And then Tyson, I mean, there goes Don Shug. I had to quickly get rid of him. Just blow him up. I didn't really want them to be successful because then they would have to continue with me in the movie. So I had to kill them off. Because they were certainly not going to do anything more than like 30 minutes of work. And then they, you know, they wanted to go about their lives. This is me talking to me. This scene was much longer. This was twice as long as this. And it's got a lot more dialogue. And I cut this down because it was just too silly. I mean, I'm me talking to me. I couldn't watch it without laughing. And this is all real stuff in my garage. A lot of chemicals in there. This is all stuff that was in my garage. None of this was brought in. This is what my garage looks like. A bunch of flammable liquids. That's because I drag race. That's all racing fuel. And that little spackle there on the bucket is, that was real. That was when I was painting the arms. And it got all this spittle of blood or whatever. Splatter of blood. And then this is a little one of our Thing latex blood patches that I brought in there. So that guy back there, he's a thing, and now my character, I realize, uh-oh, that guy back there is a thing, and I'm screwed. That's a me in front of a blue screen, and then the background plate is me, and then I kind of use Sony Vegas to blur him. That's way too bright. Should have made that darker. That's too bright. Go ahead, run. I wanted to show that the thing is getting cocky now, because this is not like Outpost 31 where he had to be secretive. He has the advantage now. The thing has the advantage, so he no longer has to play the little coy game. You know, who goes there? That wouldn't happen if he got to the mainland, because he has now got the advantage. The thing has the advantage because he's attacking us from multiple fronts now. So there wouldn't be the who goes there game that there was in Outpost 31. So a lot of people wanted to see that who goes there. That's not the way it would happen. That's, in my opinion, if the thing got to the mainland, he would be much more aggressive. It would just basically want to get within range of you, and then it would just take you over. Except for that one, it was getting a little cocky. It wanted to show me that, look what I can do. I can bust through the floor. You know, you're trying to get away, but I'm going to dig through the floor, and I'm going to get you anyway. So the one in the garage digs through the floor and comes out here as the Blair Monster because he just likes that shape. That's a really good, effective, terrifying shape. That's why he takes that shape again from the first movie. And I think we did a pretty good job on that. I think it looks like it. And a lot of these shots here is just because I wanted it on screen. I spent a month building that thing. I'm gonna leave it on screen as long as I think I can get away with it. But see, when he came through the floor, though, he got a little too cocky. He broke a gas pipe. So that's what's going on here. He just set himself up. He didn't realize it, so he's probably pretty upset with himself right now. He's probably, yep, there he goes. Man, that was a big mistake coming through the floor there. You know, he should have known better. And here comes Tyson again. Yep. That's what's left of Tyson. He turned into that. It looks just like him. That's how he looks in real life. This prop, I wish it could have moved a lot more, but we didn't. I wanted the movie to be over, so we faked it. We just kind of wiggled it around. I mean, it looks good enough. Here's our little miniature cardboard set. Here's me diving for. That's how I survived, by the way. I survived because I lay down. Fire burns up, so there's always going to be a little pocket of colder, you know, breathable air down there. And then I obviously come through a window or something and get out of there. So there I am. This is back at Mount Charleston. And that's I like this. That's a good composite. This little snowman here is to show that my struggle was not the only one that's happening. This little story is telling my struggle, but at the same time, all over the world, or all over the city anyway, there are very similar struggles happening. And this is what the snowman shows. It shows that while I was inside there, something else happened to somebody else, and they got a little bit of blood on that snowman. And this is because my nephew wanted to be in the movie again. This is my nephew who had the hands on, the thing hands. He was mad because he wanted another part, so I gave him another part. But I also, this is to show that the things are everywhere, and they somehow know if you're not a thing. So they know I'm not a thing, and he could just tell by looking at me somehow that I'm not a thing. So I'm trying to get out of there. I just completely abandoned my so-called movie son because he turned into the chess thing. But I'm heading back to Vegas. Now my goal is to get back to what's left of my family. That's what I'm thinking, you know, my character is thinking. Get back home, get my family, and try to survive as long as I can. This is me doing all these voices. I recorded it onto a CD, and I'm just playing back the CD. And it's Rockin' Ricky from Gremlins. If you've ever seen Gremlins, you'll know who Rockin' Ricky is. And then this is Robert McNamara. This is from RoboCop, the Dr. McNamara from RoboCop, the one that builds ED-209, which is the big robot that kills Kenny. So the McNamara is from that movie RoboCop. And then this is just various other little, you know, go home warnings that are going out over the radio because there's something happening. But then every time someone gets assimilated, they go on the radio and they try to calm everyone down. So there's humans getting upset, humans becoming thing, humans getting on the radio and trying to calm the other humans down. So there's a mixture of humans and things on the radio there. So you'll see, this is real snow. This is, obviously it's real snow, but I mean, this is a snowstorm that happened in Vegas, lasted like one day. So I took my camera out and filmed it. The streets really were blocked off. I did not organize this. And they did not want me filming them, so they tried to block my camera with their spotlight. That really happened. They just did not want to be on camera. I just got really lucky that it never snows in Vegas. So this snowstorm was a freak thing that helped our movie a lot. And the snow is supposed to be a symbol of the thing is just spreading over the city now because, you know, the snow was only at Mount Charleston. Now it's all over the city. Just like the thing was only at Mount Charleston. Now the thing is all over the city. And look at that wind back there. That wind is real. I had to replace my dialogue here because you couldn't hear a damn thing I was saying. There's me again with a big bright utility light back behind me. And my super cheap. I did not feel like doing that better. I just wanted to, this is near the end, one of the last things I filmed. I just wanted the movie to be over, and so that was good enough.